People are up in arms that folks are wanting to have weddings in plantations. Have you guys heard about this? Okay, this is actually a thing. People are going to plantations. I want to make it very clear that we are not talking about random plantations, but historic...
Real landmarks.
Real landmarks where slaves were held and worked on plantations, and they are having weddings there. Now, obviously, people are like, why would you ever want to get married in a place like this? And there are people that are arguing, saying that, oh, it's a beautiful venue. It's a historic landmark. Somebody said, no. How about no? It feels disrespectful. I think a lot of people feel like it feels... Zola and The Knot actually have said that they are no longer going to promote and stop posting pictures of these type of weddings.
Pinterest did too.
Yeah, Pinterest did too, because they're saying it glamorizes plantations as being elegant and classic. Others think that they're romanticizing slavery.
Right. Yeah.
And aren't there other gorgeous, like,
venues
out there?
You can get married anywhere. There's so many options. And I also looked into this because I was like, yo, are they giving them some type of major discount? That is like, no, there is no discount. They pay the same price. They want
it's about 10
to
grand.
Get married in a slave plantation.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it was a wedding planner, Allison Williams. She wrote it beautifully. She said, we sometimes forget about slavery, and you have to remember, it broke families apart. It brutally abused people, systematically raped them, and barely kept them alive. And when they die, guess where their bones end up? Under the garden where you're thinking about having your wedding.
Yes, yeah,
so
exactly.
So you have to remember that. It's like having imagine having a wedding where a Holocaust, you know, survivors or Holocaust victims were held. It's the same way.
Yeah. People feel eerie about even moving into homes where there were murders. Like, you don't even want to step foot in there because that energy, that space.
People can't even move into a house that's across the street from a cemetery, let alone having a celebratory engagement on something that held so much history and morbidity, you know?
Sadness.
Just, yes.
And people were raped and murdered. Like, why would you want to stand there and be like, well, I do?
They say because of the way, to be honest, because I did a film on a plantation.
Okay.
It was called Badasses with Danny Glover and Danny Trejo. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But we had to film on the plantation, and you could feel the spirit. But the greenery and the buildings
are beautiful. I'm sure.
But there are mansions that are not on plantations that could give you that same feel. So, you know, but I have to applaud people that are starting to not glamorize and say something about it, you know.
I have to say, because I was shooting in Louisiana, and there was a plantation there. It's Oak Valley, it's called. And I remember visiting, you know, the plantation. And I, because I'm very sensitive to energy, as you guys know, I'm just a very sensitive person. I didn't feel right there. I couldn't help but to think of the past, to think of the history. So I can only imagine your wedding day is supposed to be, you know, a happy, romantic day. And you're standing there and sensing that and feeling that, I couldn't do it.
I'm standing in a space where people were raped and murdered and things were done terribly wrong to somebody. Why would I choose that as my wedding venue to say, oh,
because some people don't care. They don't care.
Yeah, you take pictures of a venue the right way and put it at a good price, and somebody's going to completely overlook what took place there. If it had beautiful begonias and an area where you could set the ceremony, they're picturing that. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I want to say it's all about energy and intention. I think that having a wedding completely unrelated to the actual history that took place at a plantation is ignorant.
I visited to learn about
I mean, but look what Tyler Perry did. I mean, he completely built his studios on top of a Confederate Army base to reestablish what that world meant, what that happened.
Do you think that's possible to do on a slave plantation for weddings?
No.
Like, this is now a wedding venue.
No.
Yeah, I don't see that that transition being able to happen for weddings.
But this is how we stop it. We stop it by, you know, stigmatizing it and telling people, hey, it's not cool. And you don't want those type of vibes.
And stop promoting it as if it's something when it really is what we know it is.
Exactly.
Correct.